We're back with another project. This time I have an LED matrix that's 32 pixels wide and 32 pixels high. So we've got 1024 pixels. So quite a few pixels to play with. Now what I'm doing is I built this flame lamp a few years ago. Oops, rather haphazard in its construction. And of course there's a bit of breadboard. And this is no longer working. Now this had, I think there were 15 LEDs on each of these towers, and there's 20 towers, so 300 LEDs in total. And it looked pretty good. I have a link to the video, it should be somewhere around there, hopefully. Or maybe it's there, I don't know. I'm not sure how YouTube works anymore. So I'm gonna replace this flame lamp with a new version, a much higher resolution version. So let me just put this down somewhere. There we go. I put it on my pile of projects that lives by my desk. So yes, so we have this 1024 matrix LED display. Now I'm powering it off the same PCBs that I used for my crystal globes. So let's plug one of those in, and I'll show you those if I can find another cable. Let's just grab this one, and we'll use the. There we go. It's actually already plugged in. So here's one of these crystal globes. Let's turn that on. So I'm using the WLED software for all of this. So that's that one. So there's our nice crystal globe. I think you should be able to see that. So this is the moon, and the PCB is just under here. Now, this is powered by USB, so currently I'm just powering this whole LED matrix off the USB connection. Now, of course, let's just turn this off. Where's the off button? Let's unplug it. Now, of course, with 1024 LEDs, we could be looking at almost 30 amps or 40 amps required. Now, WLED does have a... Where's everything turned off now? I've lost power. Ah, because I unplugged it. What a fool. Now, of course, WLEDs does have a mechanism for limiting the amount of current. So if we look at the setup I've got here, if we go into config, go into LED preferences, I've told it to limit the current to 5 amps. It's quite high, but I'm powering it off a fairly beefy USB supply. So we can actually see what the current is being drawn at the moment. So currently we're doing about 2 amps. Let's turn the brightness up to maximum. It's 2.1 amps. And let's just change the color to white. So actually we stay around 2.1 amps. Let's go into the config and just change the, let's turn off the current limit, see if this goes up. So actually we are staying at around 2 amps. So that's pretty good. Hit save. Okay, there we go. So now we're up to 3 amps. I hope you can see that. I can't actually see what's on the camera because it's too high up because I can't actually fit all this on my desk. So let's go back. So we're on maximum brightness. Got about 3 amps. It's sort of a white color. It's not quite white. Let's see if I can actually change the color to a custom one. Nope. Don't know how to use the WLED software. Anyway, so it's around 3 amps. It's a bit high. Now, for the flame lamp, I did buy myself quite a hefty power supply. I've got here a 5-volt supply that will do 10 amps. So it's not kind of 30 or 40 or 50 amps, but 10 amps is a lot beefier than what we can get via USB. Now, the little circuit board that I use in my crystal balls, it does actually have support for external power. So let's get a bit of lighting on the situation so you can see what I'm showing. Let's turn this off. There we go, that's a bit easier to see. So this has a few diodes. So what I can do is input external power to power the LEDs and chips on the circuit board. But I've got some diodes here to protect the USB power supply. Now, the only thing I need to do is this little solder jumper here that I need to remove so that we don't try and power the LEDs via USB at the same time as the external power. So let's remove that from this little PCB here so that I don't blow things up. So we'll unplug this. It is getting quite warm, so some of these diodes get quite warm because we're not really supposed to put that much current through them. So let's get the soldering iron powered up, and I'll remove this solder jumper. Okay, so that's that solder jumper removed. We're now only drawing 0.1 amps, even though the LEDs should be lighting up, and they're not lighting up anymore, which is exactly what we want. So what we can now do is inject power straight into this LED matrix. So let's just move this out of the way. So if we flip this over, you can see what I've actually got is several of these panels joined together. So I've got 1, 2, 3, 4 panels. Now it does have these cables here for injecting power straight into the board. So what I'm going to do is connect these two wires here to our 5-volt power supply. Power will go through here, the screw terminal. It will still power the board, so our ESP32 will still power up. And then I'm just going to join these cables together, so ground to ground. We'll join all three of those and the three power ones so that we get sort of power injected right up the board. So in theory, there's probably quite a lot of voltage drop over these panels because they're quite long. But if we join these together, that should even out the power flow. So what we need to do now is just join these cables together. There is something interesting. So if you look at the actual markup on these panels, it does say 5 volts and data in. So that did worry me slightly because that's a little bit strange. But if you do a continuity check on these panels, so let's just do that quickly. So if we measure between D-in and ground, then that's actually connected. So all of the D-ins are actually ground. So they've messed up their labelling on their boards. I can't be too critical about that because I messed up the labelling on my board as well. So on my screw terminal, I swapped over ground and power. So you can't get a PCB perfect. I think a perfect PCB would just anger the PCB gods. So always good to have a little mistake so the gods don't get angry. So let's just move that over there. I really do need a bigger desk for these projects. But here we go, I'm just going to join these cables using some of these nice connectors. I don't know if these are official connectors. I got them off AliExpress, but they seem reasonable quality. So fingers crossed we won't burn the house down. So let's stick that one in there. Put that one in there. And then this one as well. And then let's do the same for the ground cables. So they should all be nicely connected. Now I just need to put these two cables into this nice DC jack socket. So let's do that. Now, assuming I've done everything correctly and my PCB is correct with all of its diodes, we should be able to plug in the 5-volt supply and everything should spring into life. So fingers crossed. Here we go, haven't tested this yet. Let's see what happens when we power this up. Well, that's pretty promising. The LEDs on the board are on, and all of these lights are on. It's actually surprisingly bright. It's probably not coming through in the camera, but that's quite bright. Let's turn it to white. Yeah, that is pretty bright. Pretty blinding. I can barely see anything now. Let's just check some of the effects. So turn on the grid effects. I'm not sure what half these are. Oh, there we go. Yep, we've got something there. DNA. Yeah, so this LED matrix is working great. So the plan is I'm going to roll this up into a tube like so. And then I'm going to put this nice diffuser on top. So I've 3D printed a bunch of support things. So we have this one lives on the top. Like, come on, get in. This one lives on the top, like, apologies for the noises. Yep, there we go. This one lives on the top. This one lives on the bottom. And then our LED matrix will live inside of this, and then have a very fancy lampshade to put around it. So I'm going to try and assemble this. I might turn the sound off for the assembly, because I suspect lots of plastic noises is going to get quite irritating. But let's get that done now.
1 eternity later.
So that actually proved to be a lot more difficult than I expected, but we've kind of got a tube shape. I think I do need to do a bit more thinking about how to form it into that shape. But it's not too bad. Let's actually see if it still powers on. Oh, there we go, we have light, so that's good. Let's just bring up the WLED software. Where's it disappeared to? Okay, so let's just try the flame effect, see if it does what we want. Okay, so that doesn't look too bad. Let's put the diffuser on, and we can put the lid on as well. This is really hard to show on my desk, just not big enough. Okay, I think that's as good as I'm going to get it for now. I think I need to revisit some of the 3D printing, because we're not quite managing to... Oh, maybe we are. Let's squeeze it on. Oh, there we go. So, oh, nope, that's come out of whack now. That's annoying. Okay, kind of there. Let's plug this back in. Not the most stable of builds at the moment. We need to revisit a few things. Let's see if we power that on. There we go. And then we switch on to the fire effect. So let's have a look. Yeah, it's not too bad. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to put the lampshade on and install this. And then we'll see how it looks. This top bit is currently not completely going on. I forgot that there are some wires here, so we'll need to reprint this top bit so it actually slides on completely. But and my power cable keeps falling out. But I'm going to install this, and then we'll see how it looks. So there we go. It actually looks really good. I'm pretty impressed with that. Quite pleased. Now, of course, we do have all the different effects that you have with WLEDs. So let's just put some of those on. Very bright, extremely, oh, very flashy as well. We do have the audio effects. I think we can make those work. So this should be something called frequency matrix. Should be responding to my voice. Frequency waves. So that's some waves of frequency, I guess. Interesting. Various different things. Don't know what these are. So yeah, but I think the flame effect is probably the nicest one. Well, that's very very flashy. Lots of flashes. I'm not sure I like that. What does this one do? Nope, don't know what that does. Oh, well, that's more audio effects. So that's responding to my voice and doing stuff. Heartbeat, I don't know what that does. Yeah, interesting. So, my new lamp works. Let's put it back to the fire effect, because that's what I was trying to build in the first place. So, let's have a look. Fire 2012. Yeah, it's a really nice effect. My flame lamp version 2 is done. Thanks for watching.